Hello everyone, today we are going to start a new section which is additional topics. In this lecture 37, we will understand what is the relationship between infotype 7 and infotype 8. So if you recall my previous lectures of time management and payroll, we came across these two infotypes. What are these two infotypes? Infotype 7 is nothing but planned working time infotype, which basically stores the employee's working time, like his daily working hours, weekly working hours, and monthly working hours. What is infotype 8? Infotype 8 is nothing but basic pay, which stores the employee's salary. So the difference of these two infotypes is, infotype 7 is related to time management, infotype 8 is related to payroll. So infotype 7 is time, infotype 8 is payroll. Let's see the relationship. It says the system takes the employment percentage and the average of working hours from infotype 7 and suggests them as default values for the capacity utilization level and working hours per period in infotype 8. So what it is telling? It is telling us, like, there are two fields in infotype 7. What are those two fields? Employment percentage and monthly working hours. So what system does it? Basically, it takes the values from these two fields, the employment percentage and the value whatever is there in the monthly working hours. So system picks those values and default these two values in another two fields which are basically related to infotype 8. What are those two fields in infotype 8? The first field is capacity utilization level and the second field is working hours per period. So system takes the values from infotype 7 and basically stores those values in infotype 8. So let's see the practically basically how the system basically stores these values. Now go to PA30, which is the transaction code for the maintenance. I am using this employee 50065. If you want to search the employee, you can go and click this particular icon and search your employee. Now I am going to infotype 7, which is basically the planned working time infotype. Let's see what is basically the working hours stored in this infotype for this employee. Now I'm clicking on the change icon. I'm looking at, okay, this employee's working hours is 8 hours. Good. Go back and go to infotype 8 and again go to change and see. Okay, so I was talking about these two fields. The capacity utilization level is coming from the employment percentage from infotype 7. And this 173 hours, which is basically monthly, this is also coming from infotype 7. So system is defaulting the values from infotype 7. Now let's go and change the values in infotype 7. I'm going to infotype 7. I'm clicking on change. What I'm doing is that I'm just changing the percentage. I'm telling, okay, these guys are not 100% employed. Basically, he's a part-time employee, like 70%. So I am just entering 70. So just to focus on the other fields, what the system is basically doing here. When I enter the percentage as 70 and hit, automatically when you press enter, system is basically is making this employees part-time. So if you see the values in other fields, it is automatically prorated based on the employment percentage, whatever I have given. So if you see what I mentioned here is the employment percentage is 70. And the monthly working hours automatically got changed to 121. So these two values now I'm storing in infotype 7. So basically system sometimes shows you some information messages, like it is telling, like, I'm making this in the correction data, but that it just ignore this information message. Hit enter. Now go to infotype 8 and then again click on change. So right now you see 100 and 173. Let's press enter. Just press enter. So what the system is basically doing? See, the capacity utilization level and the working hours per period have changed to these values. Why? Because in infotype 7, we gave the employment percentage as 70 and the monthly working hours automatically was changed to 121. Now based on the relationship between these two infotypes, the system is basically storing these two values in this infotype. Press enter. See, it automatically populated these two values. So that is the relationship between these two info types. So hope you understood this class. Thank you.